Hello friends, welcome. I just wanted to make another video and just talk a bit more about spiritual healing. Whatever form you practice that in, there's many different forms of spiritual healing around the world, such as, the way that spiritual healers do it, channel it from God, or Reiki healers, universal forces and such things. Now, the healing source is God, and even if there are healing abilities within the universe that can be tapped into, well, there's nothing in the universe that could heal us spiritually. It's God that's putting it out there in the first place. So, yeah, it all comes from God. That's the truth. I know that to be so. But, people are allowed to believe what they want to believe and where it comes from. The fact is, it doesn't really matter. It works, So you don't even have to believe it comes from anywhere, the healing ability. That you channel it, and it works. But it does help to have some belief, of course, yes. It's not good to heal from your own spirit. You become very depleted very quickly, and you become, lethargic, tired, unwell, and such like. So spiritual healing, or whatever form of healing, energy healing, should be channeled, from the source, the healing source, and let it flow most freely through yourself like an open tap, like water going through you, the healing energy, and channel it with love and compassion, because there's no stronger way or better way to give healing than to channel it like that open tap of love and compassion to the needs of the healer, the patient rather. So you heal the spirit of the patient, because it's spiritual energies that you're passing, and that heals any depletions or disharmonies of the spirit of the patient that then begins to pass on to their physical life and heal the physical life through their spirit. So now it's good practice to maybe politely ask or attune into the healing powers. I mean, many people pray to Father God for the ability to heal, and it works. You don't have to pray, it still works, but it's just polite, isn't it? Or you attune into, if you believe it comes from universal forces, you attune into that healing source in the universe and you channel it that way. And it is an attunement, spiritual healing. You do have to link in spiritually. You sort of go into a brief, peaceful state of mind and you link up into that energy, up into God, into his healing abilities, into the universal energies, whatever they might be that you want to link into. And you open your spirit up to receive those energies and begin to channel them. And they build up in you within the first minute or two of beginning to channel. And you can start to feel them flow when you become very sensitive to the patient. And it just basically fills the patient like a bottle being filled up with healing energy, like that sort of thing. And, it begins then to heal them after a minute or two. So it takes a bit of channeling just to get enough energy into them to start beginning to heal them. So you quite often start on the shoulders or wherever you start. There's different methods. Now, anything can be healed. Anything spiritual, and all life is spiritual, can be healed. So even healers in the past have demonstrated that bread that's past its best can be healed back to a more a fresh state, because the bacteria within the bread get healing, so it actually does make it slightly fresher. Some people like to Reiki their water before they drink it, heal it, and take out impurities and such like. So there's many different things you can do with the healing abilities, but greatly for humans, it's greatly complementary, and for animals too. You can heal plants, of course you can, they're life too, but it's complementary. Now, it's not an alternative therapy, it's a complementary therapy, which means just that. It does not normally cure a person's ills. It helps complement natural healing, so it will help their recovery if they can recover. So for instance, somebody with terminal cancer, you give them healing and it helps to alleviate the pain, but it doesn't cure the problem, because it's too severe for normal healing abilities to cure. It does apprehend it, slow it down, and take away the pain. So it's greatly beneficial, even if it cannot cure. It's greatly beneficial to alleviate pain and suffering mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually. So it's good, good to give anybody for any reason. And there's nothing that cannot be helped by spiritual healing. Everything can. But, you know, you can't expect miracles with it. As I say, it's complementary to aid recovery. And it does. You know, people that have got things that they're going to recover from, it can make it a quicker recovery for them and a less painful one. But greatly, it's good for pain, you know, to alleviate pain as well. I mean, I had a friend and I sent her absent healing and she'd knocked the tooth of one of her molars off and it was, you know, absolutely killing her. And she desperately come to me on the internet and said, can you send me some healing? Because I've taken everything and nothing's working. And I sent her 20 minutes healing to that tooth and it, you know, took away the pain for a few hours. But it was only for a few hours. But then she contacted me again. I sent her some more. So, you know, it helps and it's greatly beneficial. So, but it is only complementary. Now, there are some the odd healers that do seem to work miracles on people. And, you know, different patients with the same, exactly the same condition respond differently. Why that is, who knows. But it does help when a person's open to being healed and receiving the healing and accepting of it and willing to give up those things. So maybe having a for the patient to have some belief it's going to help them does help a great deal. They don't have to have faith. It's not faith healing. It's the same as faith healing, the same energy. But you don't have to have faith to be healed or to be a healer. But, you know, it does help if you're a healer to believe in it, that it works. And for the patient too, it helps if they believe it works and are open to it and accepting of it. Because the more relaxed they are, the more accepting they are of the healing, the deeper it penetrates within their spirit and helps them. So the more barriers they're putting up to thinking, oh, this is probably not going to work, it probably won't help so much. So that's why you heal one patient has a almost a miraculous, but not miraculous, but almost, you know, a great recovery they make and help them a great deal. And another person in the same condition doesn't seem to help in the slightest bit, you know, but, you know, that is maybe down to the patient. I don't know. Absolutely, that's the case. But what is allotted to one is allotted to all by Father God or the universal healing powers. So everybody from the same healer would receive the same amount of healing. Those healers work slightly differently. Spirit that work with them work slightly differently with different patients. But generally, it's all the same. Now, healing conditions. I mean, so you just give healing as a loving channel. But it's important if you're giving healing to try and have it in a nice environment. And, you know, qualifications are quite important sometimes, especially if you're doing it privately on your own, to say that you're an accredited healer, that you do it in an appropriate manner. It doesn't tell the patient whether you're a good or bad healer. It just says you've been trained to give healing and apply it properly and, you know, within an organisation. So it's not a bad thing. And, you know, liability insurance is another thing you might well need, especially if you're on your own, you know, because it's not highly recommended by most organisations that a man heals a woman on her own, you know, because of accusations that could be made, or the vice versa, a man, woman healing a man, you know. But, you know, that's up to the individual healer to decide. But, you know, you might well need liability insurance, and you find that very hard to get if you're not qualified in some way. And I mean, there's different, you know, the spiritualists do like, it's nearly 2 years of healing once a week for at least 2 hours and different qualifications. So it's quite a long process. You know, that's why a lot of people go down the Reiki route, because it's, you know, the Reiki attunement is 1 day, you know, Reiki 2 is maybe 2 days. Sometimes you can get that. It's quite expensive, but, you know, there's Reiki 3 as well, which is a few days to train to be a, but you can basically be a Reiki healer within, you know, a couple of 3 months if you wanted to be. So, yeah, it's not a bad thing to do. Now, the environment you heal in is important. And yourself, your own hygiene, because, I mean, if you're a smoker or you've got pets and that, you know, to have a healer around you when you're not a smoker, you know, and they're stinking of smoke is not nice, or that they stink of animals because they're used to it, you know, because they're with those animals all the time and don't realise they smell. And, you know, but it's a pungent aroma of an animal sometimes, and it's not very nice when you're being healed because you want to be relaxed, not smelling that. So, yeah, you know, you need to take a shower and change your clothes before you heal, and heal in a place that's, you know, free of odours. So, and, you know, a nice environment for the patient to relax, maybe have some Reiki type music on or something in the background, not too loud, and you know, a healing bed or chair for them to sit on. You know, you can have flowers there, but people are allergic to flowers, so some artificial flowers, just a nice environment for them to receive healing in, light some candles, whatever you want to do. Now, healings generally only last about 20 to 30 minutes. I mean, more than that, they don't need. I mean, if you're channeling in the correct way and method, then it doesn't take longer than 20 to 30 minutes to heal somebody fully, holistically, all over their whole body, or any specific need shouldn't take you any more than 30 minutes. People that pay for healing, well, they maybe expect a bit more, but really it doesn't do any good more than 30 minutes usually. I mean, on the very rare case, maybe 45 minutes. But, you know, Reiki healers sometimes, you know, they advertise to heal somebody for an hour, and it's pointless really, because nothing's happening for the last 30 minutes on most people. But anyway, you know, as for charging people, I mean, I go down to the Spiritist Church and just put a couple of pounds in the donation box. The healers don't charge anything. They do it for love and compassion. You know, spiritual healing, whether it's Reiki or any other form, spiritual healing is, you know, meant to be given with compassion and love for your fellow human being or animals, whatever you want to heal. And, you know, it's not about profit, is it? It's about doing it out of love and compassion, and, you know, not doing it for the profit, because it's a gift, you know, an ability to be that compassionate healer. And, you know, it's fair enough that people want to do it full time, are charging a reasonable amount, maybe 10 to 15 pounds at the present time, for a healing, you know, but some of them are charging, you know, 20 or 30 pounds or more. So, you know, it's a bit strange when people are trying to profit out of what is a gift and a natural ability, maybe. But, you know, it's fair enough people want to do it full time, they've got to charge. But mostly, you know, it should be done as freely as possible, you know. And if people want to make a free will donation, there's a donation box in the corner and they're able to do so. So that's the best way to do it, in my opinion. I don't ever want to charge for giving spiritual healing, you know, because I see it as a God-given gift, you know, and that's fair enough. Also, as I said, when you start to give healing, it's good to link in or say a prayer and say, please, Father, may I have the healing powers to channel to this person for whatever their needs might be. So you're asking God to send the right healing, not trying to do it yourself, because all you should do is let it flow through you to the patient. You shouldn't be manipulating it in any way or form, because you've got to believe it's in its most pure form when it comes to you, so you don't need to manipulate it in any way. But when you've finished healing, although I say channel it and don't use your own spiritual energies, you still do use a tiny bit of your own spiritual energies. You can't help but use a tiny amount, and you become very slightly depleted if you're doing several patients, even slightly more depleted, not that greatly. Now, the spirit, our spirit, has some small amount of healing abilities itself, but it becomes depleted, and you know, it will recharge in its own time. But if you're regularly healing, then you're never going to get to that point of being fully recharged again spiritually. So it is polite to ask Father God, or the universe or spirit guides, whatever you wish to do, after you've finished healing, please may you take any depletions that I've taken onto my own spirit away and give me recharge, if at all possible. Thank you, Father God, for hearing my prayer. So that's, you know, fair enough, isn't it? You know, that's just being polite and asking to be kept in a good condition. So, because, you know, if you do become depleted as a spiritual healer, you won't be able to channel the healing, because the more depleted you are, the less healing you can pass to the patient because of your own depletions. So the more developed and more spiritually powerful you become as a healer, as you develop, you increase your ability to channel that healing power, healing energies and powers more powerfully. So you do, you know, and highly evolved spiritual healers in the spirit realm can channel more and more energy, more powerfully, more quickly through them, because their chakra system, their spirit is highly developed and energized. So the more developed and evolved you become as a spiritual healer, the more channeling you will be able to do, and the more energy you'll be able to pass. And sometimes, you know, some healers, they don't take more than 10 to 15 minutes to heal you, because they know when they've healed you, and they are much more developed than others, and they can channel it far quicker. So it does the same thing in a shorter period of time. So the healing ultimately is not any better, it's just quicker. So anyway, that's it, you know. And sometimes it is a little better, and you know, but you know, some healers have got a natural ability to do that, and some not. You know, some can develop a good healing ability and others not. It's just like everything in life. Some can do some things better than others. That's just the way it is. You know, some healers are a little more developed and a little more compassionate maybe, or a little more something, and able to channel a bit more love and compassion and healing to the patient. So, you know, you're always going to get some better than others. But generally, you know, and I've been going to healing since 95, most healers are about the same. But if you went to a group like I go to, the healing at the church, that you will find your favourite healer, because they heal you in a slightly different way, because they use slightly different energies, some healers, because of themselves. So you do find your own Pacific healer that you got, you know, you favour quite often, yes. But, you know, there are those that heal instant healing, like just touch you and you're healed. And I'm not a great believer in that, but it still works to some extent, yes. I mean, but, you know, as I say, a healing should last 15 to 30 minutes. You know, so, yeah, you know, act appropriately, act in good accord, act with goodwill, you know, do it as giving it freely as possible, because it's a gift, from a spiritual gift for healing the sick and those that are suffering upon this world. So just do your best with it. Anyway, love and light to you. Bless you. Shep.